You're useless.
Here comes the boss.
That's the first load in.
Right, get this trailer off, head along the road.
Morning, Holly.
There we are, we can't.
Good morning. Load of fertiliser just arrived.
Right, here we go. One load of fert. I think there's four coming today. Jumping this forklift. Get it unloaded, get them away, and then go and feed the coos. Urea is horrid stuff to load because the bags are so tall, so top heavy. Just awkward things. I'll load it, I'll stack all this up, and all the top bags will fall over. That's the first load in.
In without dropping the wrap. Go on. Oh yeah.
Right, that's all that load of fertiliser in. Just got the bucket on the forklift. Need to head along the road now to the oilseed rape store where Duncan and Kev are taking dry oilseed rape to. And I'm going to push it up just to make a bit more room. It was a wee bit wet last night, so we're not getting combining first thing. There's Kev. If I'm quick enough, I can get a lift back. There goes the lorry. Anyway, onto the main road, so I'll see you on the other side. There we go, good timing. Dunk's just dipped that. I'll give it a wee shove up and then get a lift home. Just got a lift back here to yard two. Grab this machine and head back to yard one. Some days when you're going yard to yard to yard, it's like flipping logistics of moving stuff about, getting people to the right yard, machines to the right yard, then you move yard from one to another and you do it all again. But another bottle of milk for me calf.
Hey Doug,
play ball, come on, have a drink.
There we go.
You're useless,
Lulu.
What, you're not hungry?
There you go.
Right, get this cavy filled up with milk.
She's getting the hang of it.
She's not a great sucker, fairly poor, but she's taking it, and that's better than nothing.
Right, there's a few bits up at the sunflowers I need to fix. Need to put a couple of signs up of arrows. People have taken shortcuts, and now everyone thinks that's the main path, and they go off the path. They just end up walking the wrong way and getting lost.
Basically, this is the normal path, and then it's meant to carry on around here, but a few people started going that way, and once there's a wee track, everyone goes, then it looks like a main track. Anyway, put a stop in, put an arrow in there, hopefully stop people going that way.
There we go. Think that'll stop people?
I hope so.
Right, I fixed everything I need to fix. You can see the people dotted about. Group over there, group in the background, group up there on Ben Nevis, and a group in front of me. There's a lot of people dotted about, everyone's having a good time. Anyway, I'm roasting hot in the boiler suit, it's a warm day. Sunflowers are looking well just now. That is still probably 50% bloom if you look at it. Not open, not open, not open, not open, not open, not open, not open. And then there's in a similar space, there's only kind of six or seven open, so yeah, it's about 50% at the moment. Whereas on a quick glance, you'd think they're all out. Just flew my drone in here, but anyway, what's happening is rape is coming off into that trailer because that's the last of it, and Dunk and Kev have been taking it on the road to yard number four.
So that's the last load of what we cut yesterday. We've got it all through the dryer. It wasn't even dried much, so it was really quick. We started cutting today about lunchtime. It's now about maybe 10 o'clock, half 10 just now.
The amount of wee planes. Come and have a look.
Here's a picture someone commented on Facebook from their plane looking down on the field. Amazing. We're not going to be far away from filling up this shed with grain, so me and Dad are coming into this bay, which we used first. Soup it out. There's quite a lot of souping to do. There's a big floor in here. Two bays down, we need to sort out bunker walls. We're going to put a wall on that seam.
Box of tote bags, I'll show you.
There we go. We got these made for the sunflower trail. Big sunflower and gold burn on one side, and then it says hello petal on the other side. They're made from five plastic water bottles. recycled. It's good for the environment. It doesn't kill the fish.
They ran out up at the sunflowers, so I'm just grabbing another box.
Sunflowers are busy at the moment. I'm on the desk for 10 minutes while Phoebe, who's doing it, has a wee break.
Okay, I'm just back from Pool Station. Come on. Got picking up silicone. For the new concrete blocks we picked up, or we got delivered, we bought, how long ago was that? Probably about 2 months ago now. 2 months ago, we've got new concrete bunker walls, and between them, we make a silicone joint. Silicone around an edge, let it dry, then we butt them up together. Makes a better seal for the grain. So there's about 20 of them to do, so I've got a pile of these. Premium Plus 195. It was just cheap.
Siliconing is getting abandoned. Need to go sort out trailers. We're shifting field, and I'll explain it once I'm there.
This is another field, this one, which Kev and Dunk have just wiped out. Now we're taking the oilseed rape to a different yard, which only takes a wee trailer. Kev's going to put on a wee trailer. I'm going to sort out the two big trailers, get them back to the yard, get them tipped. And then the combine will keep going at yard number three.
Right, I'll dump trailer number one in here on the pit. I think Dad's needing a wee bit more to get the dryer filled up. That'll do. Don't want to run on too much rape. Straight in the pit.
That's the last of the wet oilseed rape that'll be in this trailer. There'll be a couple of loads of dry that are going to go along to a store. Otherwise, that's all the rape done.
Right, this trailer's coming off.
Right, get this trailer off, head along the road, get the other one of those, cow pit in there, and then I need to do something with it, but I can't remember what I need to do with it. I'll remember on the way there. I'm going to pick up this trailer. Kev's just pulling in, that's where the small grain dryer is, so that wee trailer is kind of all you can fit in there to get tipped in the pit, which is just inside the door. That's why we're swapping from the big trailers to the wee trailers. Right, we're yoked up here. There's not too much in this trailer. There you go, that's it. There you go, there's the wee bugs that the agronomist was picking up yesterday. Cabbage stem flea beetle. Taking them away to do spray resistance testing. So cabbage stem flea beetle are really, really, they're the worst thing for oilseed rape right now, and they munch it and they destroy it. So what they're doing is they take these away and they'll test sprays on them and see what effect it has. Basically, have the bugs become resistant to the spray, i.e. the spray doesn't work, which it doesn't work. They kind of know that already, they're just getting proper facts and figures, I guess. Dad's shifting the rape out of the way that's coming out of the spout. The spout's about to go off, and then I'll reverse under, fill up the trailer behind me, and then it will be going away along the road to a store shed that we've got. Put it into storage because we're not going to sell it right now, because hopefully prices are going to go up. Fingers crossed. Let's see if I can do this in a one-er. Line this up with a spout. No, I think I've already made a meal of it. Maybe not. Go on. That's pretty flipping good. That spout's to be in the middle. I'm going to blow my own trumpet, but I've absolutely nailed it. Right, getting this kept. This is where we're storing the oilseed rape for a wee while until we sell it. Mind the roof. That's going to go and push that all up.
Just a bit of logistics. Anyway, lights off there. Yard number two, where I'll pick up Dad again.
Go and check what the oats are like. They're just over there. Just nip out into the field, grab a few bits, and we can take it back, test it back at home, because that's where the moisture meter is. But so the bit I'm standing in right now is seed crop. Harvested, sent off to Dodd's Seed, treated, spread across the country to a lot of growers, and then sown in the ground again.
So we'll just pick a few heads. The head on that's technically called a panicle. Anyway, one of them. Another one just there. A couple there, a couple more. That should be enough to get a sample from. Straight off the bat, let's see what this crunch test. It's not bad. Straight off the bat, I'm gonna say 16%, which we'd probably go combining that, to be honest. Anyway, find out when we get home.
Here comes the boss. Chuck that in the shed, jump in here, back home.
18.2.
Between this moisture meter and the other moisture meter, this is about the fifth or sixth test. 16.7, yeah, Dad just got 16.9.
Anyway, it's about 16.17, so probably not going to go combining tomorrow.
Just getting the last of the oilseed rape in the pit here. Hopefully we'll get all this in the grain dryer. Well, saying that, you kind of don't want to, because then that means there's extra left over, and that means extra oilseed rape, which you can sell. But also, it'd be nice to get it all in and done.
getting there. I love how it flows.
This tractor's getting a bit of a drink. It's only needing about half a tank, but I'll get it filled up. So if we go combining, it's good to go.
What a corker of a night. Blue looks good in the sunshine.
We're all topped off, full of fluid. Dunk and Kev are still combining all the seed rate. They've been doing that since about lunchtime. Getting on well, hopefully get that finished tonight. That tractor and trailer I've just finished filling up with fuel and add blue. I need to fill that up with dry rape, which is going along again to the store. And then that's basically everything that's going to that store. The rest of the rape that's getting dried just now, it goes to Summer Harvest, who make like nice salad dressings and things like that. They'll press it all and produce oil throughout the year.
Right, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 done with 6 tubes to do 7. So basically a tube, a bunker wall. We do that so that when you butt them up against each other, the grain doesn't seep through. They are technically meant to be able to butt up against each other without grain getting through, but they're not perfect. So that definitely helps.
Let's jump in this machine, take that along the road to the grain store, get that dumped, get it back, then put it under the spout over there to get some more. That's the ticket, Dad's got it lined up.
Brofsky, home.
Thank you for watching. Seatbelt on. If you didn't see last video, I'm in a competition with JM Farming to reach 10,000 subscribers. The winner gets a 30-second advert in the loser's video. So please click subscribe, go on, go and click it. We're about 600 behind him, but we're catching, we're gaining. But will we do it before 10,000? Come on, let's go. I could hide neath the wings of the bluebird as she sings.